So do you think we will be able to achieve target of 4,700 megawatt by 2022 for rooftop solar?
Yes, the target is quite high, no doubt about it. But the national, if you just try to consider on the national plan, we are having almost 40 gigawatt of rooftop to be installed over the nation. Maharashtra is having a target of around about 4,700 megawatts. In the initial period, there were some hurdles, but overcoming the hurdles, we are trying to see the growth is becoming more positive, and we are committed to that. And so we'll be seeing that this target is going to get achieved. I personally feel that the target is achievable.
And what support government is providing to encourage the rooftop players?
Different sectors have been identified, and for each sector, we are trying to give some kind of an assistance which will actually help into the promotion of the solar energy and the rooftop policies. For example, for the residential, institutional and social organizations, we are giving a subsidy which is to the tune of around about 30%. For the state of Maharashtra, we are giving almost 18,300 rupees per kilowatt. For the commercial and industrial sectors also, there is some kind of an support which is being given by the government in terms of acceleration, depreciation benefit and other things. In addition to that, the high power tariffs in state of Maharashtra is a key driver to for the growth of rooftop solars in commercial and industrial organization. In addition to this, as far as a part of the government buildings, we are also trying to provide with some incentives on the which has been given by the central financial assistance. For if the work is getting completed, 80% of the work is getting completed within the sanctioned period of time, there is a subsidy of 16,250. If it gets completed, if it is lesser than 80% but more than 15%, we are having almost 11,000 of rupees of subsidies. And if it is below, if it is in the range of 40 to 50%, we are giving say 6,500. And if it is less than 40% within the sanction period, we are not giving any incentive. So in short, what we are trying to do is we are trying to promote all sectors by assisting them in some way or the others in terms of subsidies, incentives, in terms of income tax policies and other things.
And where do you see the rooftop installations in Maharashtra over next 5 years?
I am very positive and optimistic about this question, and whatever the trend we are trying to see when we are trying to address the peoples for the promotion of the renewable energy, we are trying to see that the support of the general public is quite a large. They are trying to understand the importance not only from the economical point of view but also from the environmental condition point of view, and actually these are the key drivers which I am trying to see is trying to encourage the use of solar energy in terms of rooftop. And because of the same reason, we are trying to see that whatever is the target being set by the state government, we will be in a position to complete the target with the help of the common community.
Okay. And the last question, what is the response to the net metering policy?
Net metering policy in the initial stages had some difficulties because the original traditional network, which was a unidirectional network, was getting converted into the active networks wherein the power is now going to flow in bidirectional manner. So some education, some understandings were needed to be done in the initial phases, but the utility peoples have done a quite well job on this. They have come up with all the hurdles and they have overcome with the challenges. They are trying to see the progress of the net metering. They are supporting the net metering policy in all possible manner, which is also encouraging the peoples to go into more and more net metering kind of an activity. Actually, as far as the net metering policy is concerned, one thing we have to take into consideration, here the utility has been seen as an infinite storage of batteries, and that is actually reducing the losses. We can say that is increasing the conversion efficiency. It is reducing the costing because no more batteries are going to be required. So net metering policy is actually supporting the growth of the renewable energy, especially in the solar sector for the state of
Maharashtra. As MSEDCL is concerned, MSEDCL is to support, to extend all sort of assistance to the consumers who are going to opt for rooftop solar installations. Yes, there is a necessity of creating awareness among the consumers as well as our engineers who are going to support these installations and extend the net metering installations. So, as far as possible, we are going to create an environment where consumers can be easily approached to the MSEDCL and sanctions, approvals and installation of net meters will be made easily available and process will be made simpler.
The central government has got the ambitious target of 1 lakh megawatt from solar power, and that is to be implemented by the state government. And that's why the state government, that is the Maharashtra state, as you see, designated the MEDA as the state nodal agency for the implementation of this ambitious plan. So far, the target of 4,700 solar megawatt power is concerned in the Maharashtra. A lot of coordination is required, and MEDA is especially trying very sincerely to coordinate the regulator, utilities, and the consumers by creating the awareness. Yes, initially there were some issues. Now those issues have been resolved, and now the speed has been picked up. I am having confident that definitely this massive target, although it is a massive target, will be achieved very soon. But the education of the consumers, education of the public, education of the engineers from the utilities must gain the top priority, so that this speed, existing speed, will get little bit acceleration, and the target will be achieved. This is the global need, country need, state need, and consumers need also.